What is up, guys? Mr. The Reverts here, and Australia has ordered loot boxes are now psychologically linked to gambling. So what does this mean for the future of your video game that may contain loot boxes? Are they gonna go? Are they gonna stay? Let's take a look. Obviously, we all kind of had a feeling that, sure, there is some kind of an addictive tendency that manifests from purchasing loot boxes, but now there's actually solid proof of this. And over the past few months, loot boxes have been under fire a little bit recently, mainly coming out in August, where the government of Belgium banned the sale of loot boxes in games. And then last year, the Chinese government came to a similar conclusion because China said that all games now have to disclose the drop rates of the contents inside a loot box. And then, of course, the state of Hawaii has been having their own battle with getting a bill passed to deem loot boxes illegal. So there's a good majority of political figures and governments that want loot boxes to be banned, or at least make the buyer have a warning that states their odds of actually getting the item they want. But again, most recently here, this study found from the Australian Environment and Communication Reference Committee conducted a study of 7,500 gamers and how they respond to games that primarily have a chance-based game, and 7,500 people is a pretty dang large number, so the data here is more than enough to be sufficient. And lo and behold, they found loot boxes are psychologically akin to gambling. One of the points made in the study here is pretty interesting. So they say spending large amounts of money on loot boxes was associated with problematic levels of spending on other forms of gambling. This is what one would expect if loot boxes psychologically constituted a form of gambling. It is not what one would expect if loot boxes were instead psychologically comparable to baseball cards. So pretty much here, a lot of these publishing studios have said, oh, loot boxes, they're just similar to buying baseball cards or basketball cards or even Yu-Gi-Oh cards. So when you open up your pack, you obviously get maybe one rare card out of the five other cards that you have that may be somewhat decent or at least bad. But regardless though, they still have some form of monetary value. Like, you can still use them in order to upgrade to maybe something better or sell them and get some money back from them. But with loot boxes, you don't really get that. Sure, you get maybe one good weapon or one good item from a loot box, but the rest you don't really use, like, ever. So definitely it's not comparable to baseball cards or Yu-Gi-Oh cards in any way, shape, or form. Again, a lot of publishing studios have said that, but it's not, so that's just completely false, and this study definitely does address that. Also, the study showed that loot boxes could act as a gateway to problem gambling, which basically is when someone has the urge or the compulsion to gamble continuously despite the negative consequences, such as spending all of your hard-earned money come out of it. Now, one of the recommendations were that games with loot boxes should be restricted to players of the legal gambling age, depending on where you live. And also, these games should have warnings and parental advisories that state loot boxes are going to be in the game. Once again, this is pretty dang huge for the gaming scene, because all of these governments and politicians are going to come together and think about it and say, hey, our children are getting hooked on this. Something like this needs to be put to an end. So in this study, these are the three main points that the ECRC wants to pass, and this is what the government officials are going to be looking at. So one, games containing loot boxes have parental advisory stickers on them that state that there are loot boxes. Two, games containing loot boxes have a description that indicates the presence of online gambling. And three, consideration is given to restricting games with loot boxes to players of the legal gambling age. So what do I think will happen in the future? Either publishers and game developers are gonna have to come up with a workaround, kind of like how, you know, in Fortnite, you know what you are buying, or what the Chinese version of Overwatch has done. So for example, they are gonna sell you credits, and with those credits you can buy a voice line, skins, etc. firsthand, instead of playing like a slot machine. It's a little bit of a workaround, but I for sure do not see microtransactions in video games going anywhere. The gaming companies make way too much money to let them go. Now, for Black Ops 4, I wouldn't be surprised if there's a little bit of a change-up this year with how microtransactions are going to work. I wouldn't be surprised either if they head more towards the direction of Fortnite with the V-Bucks system this year. But more than likely, we will not have any more information on supply drops or a market system until like the week Black Ops 4 comes out. Because it's well known that COD fans do not like supply drops and anything that has to do with that. So I guarantee you they're not going to let anything be made public until that very first week of Black Ops 4. Now, for me personally, I do not have an issue with buying microtransactions or something that I know what I'm going to be getting firsthand. Because at the same time, it does help out the game developers with a game that I enjoy playing. Plus, I'm going to be getting a really cool skin or a really cool weapon, etc. So there is kind of a balance there. However, I do have an issue with paying cash for something that I have a chance at getting. Keyword there is chance. And that's where the balance kind of becomes a little unfair. So definitely, if anything, we may start to see a trend of changes with how micros are going to be working with all these bills and studies coming out, just so publishing studios and developers can avoid the legal aspects of everything. But let me know what you guys think about this down below in the comment section. Also, drop a like if you guys did enjoy. And thanks for watching. Until next time, I'll see you guys later.